Now, crystal field theory. So, this crystal field theory involves an purely electrostatic approach to the bonding complexes. So, it was first applied to the ionic type of crystals, that is the crystalline substances. So, therefore, it is very often called crystal field theory, or simply we can write it CFT. So, this theory considers the metal ion as being placed in a electrostatic field created by the surrounding molecules or in the ions. So, the electric field changes the energy of the d electron in case of the transition metals ion, that is d orbitals. So, many of the properties of the complex are related to the energy changes. So, this theory considered the bonding in the complex to the entirely electrostatic. See, now already you seen that shape of the d orbital. Already you were studied in structure of atom, and you were studied in class 11 the shape of the d orbitals. Here they have dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square, and dz square. So, they have 5 set of d orbitals are possible. So, these are called degeneracy orbital. They have a same energy, all these orbitals having the same energy. Look at this, this dxy, dyz, dzx. These having this the axis, this the loops are present in the between the axis. All the loops are present in the between the axis. So, they are called as T2G orbitals. Simply we can write it, that is the set of orbital is called T2G orbitals. Then look at this. The here the x, y and z, that is dx square minus y square and dz square having the loops are along the axis. So, we call it as, that is EG orbitals. Okay. See how to draw the crystal field splitting energy for tetrahedral and the octahedral complexes. Now, we will see. So, before that, the ligands which cause the greater crystal field splitting are termed as strong ligand, while those which cause lesser crystal field splittings are weak ligand. So, this increasing order of the field strength is called a spectrochemical series. So, up to this water molecule, up to H2O, these are called weak ligand, and hereafter they are called strong ligand. So, I minus is less than, Br minus is less than, SCN minus is less than, Cl minus is less than, S2 minus is less than, F minus is less than, oxalate 2 minus is less than H2O, like this. So, up to this is weak field ligand, and here up from here to here is strong field ligands. Now, we will see the octahedral crystal field stabilization energy diagram.
Metal consists, that is d orbital, the 5 d orbital which are present the metal we call degeneracy d orbital. This degeneracy of d orbitals having the same energy. So, the electrons enter into the all the 5 d orbital. See here, look at this, for example, a complex having, this is for octahedral, so that the example is CO F6 3 minus and the CO NH3 6 times 3 plus. See, this having the ligand here, the two ligands are fluoride ion and the ammonia have approaches, the approaches to the metal 5D orbital. So, what happens mean? Here, the fluoride ions and the NH3 ion, or sometimes you can use it, the cyanide ions also. Cyanide ion also you can use it. Approaches metal, what happens means, there will be some repulsion. That is, the repulsion maximum means they lose the degeneracy. So what happens? So energy is rise. So energy is rise between when an octahedral complexes. So this is the octahedral complexes. Ligand approaches along the axis. So EG orbital energy is rise because the EG orbitals have it along the axis. Already we seen that diagram, that is dx square minus y square, then dz square. So they have EG set. So they have energy along the axis, orbitals are along the axis. So energy is rise. So you have to write in the top, that is EG. So they have dx square minus y square, then dz square. Next is, in look at the T2G orbitals. The loops are, usually the loops are present in the, between the axes. So they have the very repulsive force. This having very high repulsive force. This having the very less repulsive force. So energy is lower. Okay. This splitting is called crystal field stabilization splitting or crystal field splitting energy. See, this here the totally 5 d orbitals are there. In this having energy is rising. Among this two, 3 is energy is needed, so that 3 orbitals and energy is rising, so that plus 3 by 5, because of 5 is 5 d orbitals are degeneracy orbitals are there. Similarly, energy is there, less repulsive forces are there, so that energy is lower, so negative sign is there. So this is 2 by 5. When 3 by 5 is 0.6, that delta naught value, so 3 by plus 3 by 5 is 0.6 and plus 2 by 5 is 0 minus 0.4, that is delta naught. You have to tell this is not a delta naught, this O indicate for octahedral crystal field. The delta naught, the crystal field stabilization energy is delta, is not indicate, the O indicates for octahedral complexes. Okay, this now we will discuss the tetrahedral complexes, just opposite of this octahedral complexes. So energy is rise when T2G energy is rising and the EG energy is lower. See now the tetrahedral complexes. Look at here the tetrahedral complexes also. Degeneracy of the orbital. There is no changes because they have all the 5 d orbitals having the same energy. Here in excited state they have, that is non degeneracy of the d orbital, or you can tell that is average energy of the d orbital. Here when the ligands are approached between the axes, then the T2G will be having the higher energy. The T2G having the higher energy, EG having the lower energy. In a tetrahedral complexer, according to the spectroscopy, you should not mention that G, gerade you should remove. So here T2 and E. This indicates, according to the spectroscopic studies, you should mention only the T2 and E for the tetrahedral complexes. In octahedral complexes, you can tell T2, G and the EG. Here, just in tetrahedral complexes, T2G, that is T2 is higher energy. In octahedral complexes, EG is higher energy. So here, the delta T indicates there is crystal field stabilization energy for tetrahedral crystal field. So delta T indicates tetrahedral, and that case O indicates for octahedral. This value is plus 2 by 5 because of 5 degeneracy orbitals are there. So 5 denominator you put 5, and the among the 3 orbitals you have to remaining what have 2, so that plus 2 energy is rising, so that plus 2 by 5 delta T, and energy is lowered for this E value, e orbital, so minus 3 by 5 del t. So this is for the tetrahedral complexes. Now we will see the limitations of the crystal field theory.